All right, so let's pick up where we left off. We talked about IDE, hard drives and ROMs. I'm gonna pass around a couple of zip drives. Y'all know what zip drives are? Like large floppies. These also go on IDE cables.
All the things you're passing around are currents, correct?
Yes. Yes. Alrighty, now, we have on our motherboard our two IDE connections, right? What do you connect into what? On older computers, whenever you go through the boot process, whenever you turn on a computer, the hard drive that has your operating system on it, the hard drive that has Windows on it, should be on your primary master. Okay? The hard drive that has your operating system on it should be on your primary master on older computers. On newer computers, you can select which drive to boot to. But on older computers, you won't have that option from the BIOS. Okay? So just to let you know, on some older computers, you're going to want your OS on your primary master. Okay?
How do you know which ones are the older?
Well, you'd be able to tell by the peripherals that are on them, the connections that are on them. And most of the time, just by looking at them. You know, if it has the older RAM, then that's one big heads up. Mm-hmm. Older processor, same thing. All right, but you could always just open up the BIOS and look into it, see what options are on there, and so on. All right, so we had our two IDE connections there. Right next to that, we have another connection, another parallel ribbon cable connection. It looks like an IDE, but it's a little bit smaller. Did anybody try to plug in your IDE cable to it? It didn't fit because the IDE cable is too big. That is for your floppy. For your floppy. And let me grab the floppy cable. I'm going to pass around your floppy cables. Looks like so. Be careful with some cables. Some of the holes are blocked off to signify which end it goes to. All right? For instance, this one. There's not a single blocked off one. All three of these have one side blocked off. Actually, some of these have both sides blocked off. All right, but this one's a universal cable. That means that that can use any motherboard or any floppy on this one. Then I'm gonna pass around a couple floppies. Now, when it comes to floppies, here you go. Here you go. You're going to have floppies with different faces. Some are going to look like this, and others are actually going to have a face. The ones that look like this are for the computers like the ones in front of you today that have the front of it built into the front panel. This one is for the type of cases that you are going to upgrade to. For instance, if I wanted to put a floppy on this computer, in this section here, I would get one that has a face on it. Okay, because there's nothing built into here. If I wanted a floppy for the computers that are in front of you, I'm going to need this one that does not have a face on it because the face is built into your case. And this would just butt up against it and you'll be able to use it. Okay, in case you don't know what a floppy drive looks like, here's one right there. These are all floppy drives.
For
us as computer technicians, sometimes to load specific drivers during our operating system installation, like if you instead of putting your operating system on a hard drive, you want to put it like on a RAID or on a different type of hard drive named SCSI, or on a controller card, then you're gonna have to load the drivers using a floppy. For regular people, I have no idea what they might use it for. It's not very big, maybe Word files and text files, and that's about it. Small Excel spreadsheets. All right, so that's our floppy connection. If this two of the cables that I sent out to you will fit on here, one of them won't. This one's a universal one. It will plug into.
We're supposed to look at them and pass them.
Uh-huh.
Oh.
Yes. The floppy ribbon cable also has a red wire. What is the red wire for?
Pin one.
Pin one. And if we look at our floppy, we have a 34 over here and a 2 over here. So we know that number pin one is on this side, 35 is on the other side. So the red wire goes on the side that has the 2, which signifies pin one. Okay. Floppy. We have IDE connection, we have a floppy connection. The next type of connection that we have would be serial ATA or SATA. On your boards, the serial ATA connection is right here with these white pieces. Now this white piece does come off, so it might look like that, okay? So if we look at this way, we can see our SATA connections on it. Look at mine up here, look at it through the side of it, okay? These are SATA cables. They come in various colors. They will come in red, orange, blue, black, all sorts of different colors. They are all the same thing. The color has nothing to do with it. These are all SATA cables. Some SATA cables have a 90 degree head. Others have straight heads. If you have one with a 90 degree head, that's going to be for your SATA hard drive. Okay? It will go in.
So is the SATA a newer technology? Or?
Yes, this is the newer technology. Goes in like so. Though the heads are interchangeable, you can switch from one side to the other and you're perfectly fine. So I'm gonna pass around a couple SATA hard drives. I want you to notice the connector has an L on it. Okay, everybody see that? It has an L on it. That the connector on the hard drive and the connector on the motherboard also has an L on it. So go ahead and take your cable. Everybody grab a cable. Should be right by your desk. And enter that into SATA 1, like so.
You can have different types of hard drives on
one. You can pick on that motherboard specifically, yes. So there's gonna be a couple of SATA hard drives going around. And actually, I'll put one per group here. SATA one.
Closes in an L configuration.
Yet some other boards have more SATA connections than others. This one has 4. Some of them have 6. It just depends how many you need. Okay. Now, what do we notice about the SATA cable versus the IDE cable?
A lot smaller.
Smaller? Thinner? Slicker, anything else?
Easier.
What do you mean by easier?
Plug.
It's easier to plug, easier to connect, easier to take out. But also, there's only one connection on each side, right? So how many drives can I put on this plug?
One.
Just one. So on your motherboard with 2 connectors, how many SATA hard drives can I put on it?
Two.
Just 2. One per connector, that's it.